Hello everyone, this is me Vinod Kumar Singh. I am going to start a new chapter from economics. Chapter name is development and the topic we will deal today, human development and economic development. Learning objectives of today are, we will learn about the meaning of development. We'll be also understanding about the goals of development. As you know, different people have different developmental goals. So we'll discuss about the goals of development, and we will also discuss about how can we aware ourselves that what we live today, how we live today, the way we live today is affected by the past. So let's begin. So a simple definition of development is, development is a positive growth and change in economic, social and political aspect of a country. Positive growth means something in addition, yani kuch hamare paas naya jud raha hai, that is in positive way. Okay, it may be in the economics, it may be in social order, it may be in politics. So development we can classify here of two type. One is human development and the other is economic development. Human development. So we are, when there is increase in the value of human being, when there is training to be given to the human being or job opportunities are provided to the human being, so we are calling this all human development. Why? Because human is adding something in his, her talent, something in addition. So when something is added to the human being, it may be health wise, it may be the skill, it may be his wiseness, or it may be the health. So any kind of this addition is given into the human being, it is a kind of human development. Now, if we talk about economic development, so here with the picture it is clear, we are increasing the cost, we are increasing the value. So when the income generation is increasing, when the production is increasing, our income generation is increasing, we can call it economic development. So firstly, we'll deal here with human development and economic development, differentiate between. What is human development? Human development is centered around the human approach. Means we are, all thing we are discussing and dealing about the development, about the improvement of human being. We are discussing about and dealing here about overall development of the human being and the good quality of life of the individual. Means totally we can say human development is the development of human being all around, all over. Overall development of human being is human development. But when we discuss about economic development, it means that continuous and sustained growth in an economy. Continuous means without break. Break nahi hona chahiye. Economic development continue jayega. And sustained growth means the growth must not be fluctuate much. Okay. Sometime the growth rate is 8% and sometime it goes very down, maybe 2%. Okay. So such like development is not good. Sustained growth means if the growth rate is around 6%, 6.5, again 6%, 6.57, so it means the growth rate is sustained. Okay, so sustained growth rate must be there. Okay, along with a general improvement in overall standard in a nation. Next, in human development, you can see here, it is indicated by Human Development Index. In short, we are calling it HDI, Human Development Index. So this index is prepared by UNDP. a United Nations Development Program. It is generating this index, preparing this index. In economics, economic development, it can be indicated by national income and per capita income. We'll discuss about this, what is national income and what is per capita income, in the following terms. We'll discuss it. Okay. So, it means here, you can see one more point is given here. It is a wider term, includes economic development also. Means in human development, everything comes. In human development, it comes what? That education, health, training, all thing, even it is related with the well-being of human in all kind, as well as economic development means money related issue is also coming under human development. But when we talking about economic development, it is a narrow term. Why it is a narrow term? Because economic development only dealing with the income criteria. We can see here national income means income of the country and per capita income means per person income. So, it is dealing with economic development is dealing with only economic term means income term. Next, you can see here the three characteristics of development. The first is here, different people can have different developmental goals. Means, if as you know that people have different situations, so their developmental goals means what is development for a person or what is development for the other person, it may differ. We'll discuss this with example. Next is, what may be development for one may not be the development for other. Even sometime it may be destructive for other. Okay. This also we will discuss again. People tend to look at a mixed goal for their development. Means development should be of variety. It should not be only one type development. It should be complete development. So, people generally look for a mixed kind of development. Here, the first point we are going to discuss here, different people have different notion means idea of development. So, different people have different idea for development. What are those can be the ideas? Like, it depends upon the situation of the people. Where the people is living, what is the condition of people, what is the economic condition of the person, and the location where they are living, what facilities they are already having, and what facilities they are required. So, it is all about depending on the situation around them. Now, first example you can see here, if a person is living in a remote village, which is not accessible by road, means ek village area mein reh raha hai person aur road se connectivity nahi hai, then construction of an all weather road would be the development for him. Like you can see in this picture, it is the scene of a village. This road is providing the connectivity from the village area to the town. Then it is a development for those people who are living in village area, okay, and they were not having the connectivity from their village to town. It may be they were having road, but that was not all season road. But now all weather or all season road, when they are getting a pakka road, they are getting which is connecting to their town area, then it is a development for them. One more example is here. This you can see here, many people are waiting for metro train. So, if a person is living in a metro city and finds it difficult to commute to his workplace, construction of rapid transit system would be the developmental need for that person. So, for these like people who are working in some organizations in private or in public organization, and daily they have to go many kilometers, they have to go and they have to come also, means coming and going every day they have to go. So it is becoming very difficult for them if the means of transport are not provided in the right way. But here suppose a metro train has been provided to their workplace, or in this way they can easily go to their place and come back again to their home easily. So this will be a development for those people who are willing to travel in this way. Next point is here, development for one may not be development for the other, even it may be destructive. Firstly, you should understand the meaning of these words only. Development for one may not be the development for other. So as already we have discussed, the development, meaning of development always depend upon the situation, and sometime it may become destructive also, yani ki barbadi ka karan ban sakta hai for some category people. So example one is here, construction of a flyover to reduce waiting period at a railway crossing can be development goal for an office worker. But if the construction of flyover requires to remove the slums, it can be against to the slum dwellers. Now in this picture you can see here the flyovers are given in this picture. This flyover definitely going to help the people to move easily, to cross the railway line easily, to move from the very traffic area, they can move easily and cross those all traffic area so easily and reach their destination very quickly, very faster, in very less time period. Okay, this is a good facility. But if this facility, means flyover to be constructed, we require to remove the slum area, then it will be a problem for those who are living in slum area. So here now coming back again to these words, that is what development for one may not be development for other. So some development for the people who are living in the city area and they wanted to go to their workplace and some flyover is made. So this is development for the people who are going to use this road, okay, use this flyover. But if we talk about the slum area people, their houses has to be demolished, inke houses tod diye jayenge aur yahan pe fir flyover banaya jayega. So definitely it is destructive for them, kyunki unke ghar bhi tootenge, unki जो अर्निंग्स जुड़ी हुई हैं इन जगहों से रिलेटेड, तो उनकी अर्निंग भी जाएगी, लिवलीहुड भी छिन जाएगी उनसे, और उनका प्लेस भी उनसे छिन जाएगा. तो इट विल बी अगेंस्ट टू देम, राइट. नाउ नेक्स्ट एग्जांपल वी हैव फॉर द सेम, अ डैम हैज टू बी कंस्ट्रक्टेड. तो अ डैम मे बी अ डेवलपमेंटल गोल फॉर एन इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट और फॉर दोज पीपल who have been given the supply of electricity. So maybe the industries will be given the supply of electricity, or the city areas where the supply of electricity will be given. So they will be so happy to get 24-hour electricity, continuous without fluctuation electricity they will be getting. It will be a development for them. But what about the people who may living in these areas? I am talking about these areas where this dam has to be constructed. Okay, before the dam has to be constructed, the population must be living there. Okay, now that population has to be removed from their places. Okay, they have to leave these places and move to some other places, some elsewhere. Okay, so this population definitely they'll start some movement. They will start raising their voices, and even you can see here, can imagine that their life is in danger, their livelihood is in danger. This is the photograph I have taken this lady is Medha Patekar. Okay, she has started Narmada Bachao Andolan. The dam has was to be constructed on Narmada River. Okay, and presently the dam is built, constructed already, and started also. Right. So Sardar Sarovar Dam. Okay, that was to be built on Narmada River. So this movement has been started by the people who were living in those areas where Sardar Sarovar Dam had to be constructed. So they were against the construction of this dam. Okay, and she was the leader of Narmada Bachao Andolan, Medha Patekar. Thank you for watching this video. Bottles popping, bottles.